How do you add this level of dynamic realism to a static bathroom scene? And more importantly, how do you render a complex liquid simulation animation like this without waiting for days? Today, we are bringing this beautiful bathroom scene to life. We'll be using Chaos Phoenix to simulate a running shower, and then we'll be using the Live Link to render the whole animation inside Chaos Vantage. This is a powerful and incredibly fast workflow. So let's get started. As always, we're starting inside 3ds Max. Make sure your scene is organized before you follow along, just so you don't get confused. First up, the liquid simulation. To tell Phoenix where the water should come from, we need an emitter mesh. You could create your own simple cylinders, but here's a much faster pro tip. Let's just use the mesh from the shower object itself. With the shower head selected, go to Edit Mesh and select the Elements sub-object. Just select the little nozzles where the water would come out, and then detach them. They are now a new, separate object that we can use as our emitter. Now, in the Phoenix taskbar, press the Liquid Source button and create one in your scene. Under its properties, let's change the velocity to 40 millimeters and add a noise of 0.25. This noise is great for breaking up the stream and making it look less like a perfect computer-generated cylinder. Now, it's time to choose the emitters we just created. Just select them and add them to the list. This is where the particles will spawn. Before we create the main simulation grid, I wanted to share something new and exciting with you. I've just launched a brand new community Discord server. It's the perfect place for us to connect more directly. If you have questions about this tutorial, like this Phoenix setup, or want to get feedback on your own projects, or just want to chat with other like-minded archviz artists, then come and join us. It's also the best way to stay up to date with all my new uploads and content. The link is right down in the description. I'm really excited to build this community with you, so come and say hi. Next, we need to create the simulation area. Under the Phoenix menu, create a liquid sim object and place it in your scene. This grid is basically the container where all the physics will happen. The best way to set this up is to adjust the grid to perfectly match the shower cabin, fitting it to the walls and the floor. And of course, make sure your emitters are inside of it. Under Grid, let's set the voxel size to 2 millimeters. This is your main quality setting. A smaller number means higher detail, but also a much longer simulation time. 2 millimeters will give us around 200 million voxels, which is a great balance. To make sure the water stays in the cabin, set all the container walls to jammed both. Under the Dynamics tab, activate Gravity and set steps per frame to 2 for a more stable, accurate simulation. I'll also add a surface tension strength of 0.1, which helps the water droplets clump together realistically. Finally, under Preview, turn Show Particle Preview off and activate Show Mesh. This gives us a much clearer preview of what the final rendered water will look like. Now, let's add a bit of animation. I don't want the shower to be on from frame 1. I want it to turn on. Quick note about my timeline. You might see 300 frames. I was originally playing with 60 frames per second, but decided to switch back to 30 frames per second to save on render time. The important part here isn't the total length, but the keyframes on our liquid source. I want the water to start pouring after about 1 second. So at the beginning, until frame 25, the outgoing velocity will be 0. Then at frame 30, I'll set a new key with our full velocity of 40 millimeters. To run the simulation, just press the Start button in the Phoenix toolbar. You can see the progress right in your viewport, and on the right, you'll see a progress bar. Now just wait for it to finish. let's prepare the rest of our scene for the Vantage Live Link. As we've learned, a V-Ray Sun and V-Ray Sky work the best inside Vantage. In the V-Ray Sky settings, I'll select our V-Ray Sun and choose CIE Overcast for that nice, soft, diffused light. I'll change the sun intensity to a very subtle 0.05 and set the size multiplier to 2.0 to get softer shadows. Now, let's apply a material to our Phoenix liquid. You can choose the standard liquid materials, but I want a slight bluish color. Therefore, I'll go with a clear acrylic material and just brighten up the refraction color. And now, this is the most crucial step to make this work with Vantage. You must add an Edit Poly modifier to the Phoenix FD liquid object. If you forget this step, it simply will not render in the Live Link. Okay, now it's time to run the V-Ray scene converter to change all our materials to V-Ray. And then, let's start the Vantage Live Link. Inside Vantage, we'll go through the usual steps of changing our color correction and render settings. I won't change the environment and camera settings here because the Live Link is pulling those directly from our 3ds Max scene, which is exactly what we want. I'll quickly adjust the render settings. I always use Ultra settings, 4 bounces for GI, and switch Reflective GI Caustics to Full. For reflections and refractions, I'll change it to 15 bounces. So here is where the magic happens. You can just get creative and position your V-Ray cameras inside 3ds Max. You can animate a full camera movement using keyframes on the timeline. Just make sure to set the keyframe movement to linear so you get a smooth, steady shot. In this process, Vantage is a true lifesaver. You can always check your final viewport render in real time just by switching over to the Vantage window. To bring even more life to this animation, I'll also animate the sun's movement to give it a sort of time-lapse vibe. Just change the position and height of the sun and animate it using Auto Key. When you have your animations ready, just go back to 3ds Max and press the Render Animation via Live Link button. Choose the camera you want to render and open up Vantage. Inside Vantage, choose the scene state that contains all your color correction adjustments. Choose the correct resolution, and most importantly, choose the correct frame range. Then, save it as a PNG sequence and let it render. And that's it. You have successfully created a complex liquid simulation with Chaos Phoenix and rendered the entire animation in a fraction of the time using the Chaos Vantage Live Link. It's a truly powerful combination. I really hope this tutorial was helpful and showed you a new workflow. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.